Hey, John, drop your phone. And action.
Welcome back, guys. Today, I have a special guest with us. It's one of the owners of Start Skydiving, Alex Hart's father, John Hart.
Special.
He is special. Yes. And today we're going to do an informative series about the components of a skydiving rig. Specifically, we're going to focus on a sports skydiving rig that a licensed skydiver would use in freefall. The first thing about a skydiving rig is we wear it pretty much like a backpack with some leg straps. Would you say that's accurate?
Yeah, it just doesn't have any snacks inside.
Well, I think some people probably pack some snacks up there. Would you like to put it on for us and show us how it fits and how it goes on? Now, we all have our unique ways of getting skydiving rigs on. Depends on how flexible you are.
Not flexible.
John's got that method. It's not the one I use, but that's all right. We'll forgive him.
It's worked.
It's worked for 20,000 jumps, huh?
Exactly.
So far, he's got his leg straps on, and what he just did was take this chest strap, and he routed it through right here, and now it's secured. And the next step, he's going to tighten these leg straps. And that's what makes him nice and even in the harness when the parachute deploys, it's going to be nice and comfortable for him.
Yeah, I always check both straps, make sure they're the exact same length. That way on opening, I'm not kind of twisting one way or the other.
Yeah. All right. So, John, you're ready to go. I could do a gear check on you, which we'll talk about how to do a gear check in another episode. Because right now, we're just going to talk about all the different components of this skydiving rig. We call it a rig.
It's a rig.
It's a rig.
Not a backpack. It's a rig.
Lots of different things here for safety. Up at the top here, the first thing we have, these are the connection points for the risers. And that's what connects to the parachute that's in the back. Up here, we've got a three-ring system. You see right here, this ring, we've got a smaller ring, and then an even smaller ring. And through here, it's connected through to the back side where there is a cutaway cable that's coming through. And that cutaway cable is routed all the way through to this handle right here. When do we pull that handle?
The John handle. Only if I need to.
That's right. This is to cut our main canopy away because for some reason or another we had a malfunction and we'd like to get rid of it. And the great thing about skydiving is it's incredibly safe because we have two parachutes.
That's right.
Turn around, we'll show them where they are. All right, the main parachute that you use for all the jumps is right down here and we'll show you how to pack that in another episode. And up here we've got the reserve parachute. It's packed every 180 days by a certified rigger. And we'll bring our riggers in at some point into these episodes so you can meet them.
I hate being on camera.
So that's up here, the reserve, the main's down here. All right, let's turn back around, John. So we're talking about cutting away the main because we gotta get our reserve parachute out in an emergency, right?
Right.
What does this one do, John?
That is a red handle. And it is for deploying my reserve.
All right. So we've gone over the risers, we got the three-ring release system, which has that cable connected to it. And you'll see here, this cable, it goes about this far down into the housing. So when that handle gets pulled, this cable comes out, and all of a sudden these three rings can release and that whole parachute goes away. Now,
it works.
It does work. We both know.
Knots.
Yep.
It's worked every time.
Yeah. Very, very safe.
Yeah.
All right, so what else is up here is our reserve static line. Now, some jumpers use it, some don't. It depends on the situation and what discipline you're doing. We are both canopy relative work pilots, so we do not use the reserve static line, but most skydivers do, especially when they're in free fall.
The RSL assists in deploying the reserve. You should still pull your reserve hand.
Absolutely, yep. On the back of the rig, at the very bottom, we have the bottom of container, VOC, pouch for the pilot chute. The pilot chute is all tucked away in here. It's nicely packed away. All right, John, let's see you deploy that pilot chute as though you're in free fall. You're done with your free fall and you're ready to open that main canopy up and fly. There you go. So the pilot chute gets thrown away into the relative air and it's gonna inflate with air and it'll pull out our main canopy. Now, it's connected to a bridle. You can see right here, this is our bridle. On it, it has a closing pin. There's a closing pin right here, and that closing pin gets routed through our closing loop. You can see this closing loop right here. It's pulled all the way here, and that closing loop is what's keeping all of this bottom area all together, nice and neat. So as soon as this bridle gets pulled, this pin is gonna come out of this closing loop. All right, so what just happened was John threw this, his pilot chute grabbed that relative wind, it inflated, and as a result, it's pulling this bridle, and it's gonna pull that closing pin out of that closing loop. There we go, it's opening this. I'm not as strong as the wind, huh? And out comes his deployment bag. Now, if John were to have to deploy his reserve, let me show you what the reserve flap looks like in here. Here is the closing pin and closing loop for the reserve. The reserve has a spring assist to it, so it's gonna pop out really hard and really fast because it's important. If we need to use the reserve, we need it fast. So it's gonna come out right through here. Another component you're gonna see up here is an AAD, or automatic actuation device. It's electronic and it can sense how fast the skydiver is falling through the air. John, do you wanna talk to us about the AAD and what it's done for the world of skydiving?
Well, it's revolutionized it because when skydiving first started, there was nothing called an AAD. The first generation were little windups, and now they're all electronic, computerized. They have a pretty long shelf life. An example, a sport jumper is doing a large formation and is unconscious and cannot get to their handle to deploy their main parachute or to their handles to drop their main and do the reserve. It will automatically deploy the reserve parachute for that skydiver, and it saved a lot of lives. At Start Skydiving, we recommend and encourage that all jumpers have an AAD that are doing free fall work. We don't require it for our canopy relative work pilots, but we do recommend for our sport skydivers.
If it senses you're going at a certain rate of speed at a specific altitude lower to the ground, that's when it says, this isn't safe. I think I need to go ahead and deploy this reserve for the jumper. And it does it automatically.
And we use the Cypress system here at Start Skydiving through SSK. Great system, very proud to use it.
And the same systems are in our tandem rigs as well, and our student rigs. So we use them across the board. The other thing you can tell here about the reserve is there's a seal. You see this red thread? That is from the rigger. And this is a piece of lead, and on the lead right here, it has ROX. That happens to be our rigger here at Start Skydiving, Brian Marsloff. And this is his rigger seal. So he has sealed this shut, and we're gonna look at that and make sure when we check this rig in to jump here at Start Skydiving that this matches the reserve repack card, so that John is nice and safe to jump. All right, here's a pilot chute that John just threw out into the wind, and it pulled his deployment bag right out of his container. The container is basically the backpack portion. It holds everything. So now from there, it's gonna pull the risers that you saw on John's shoulders right out. There we go. All right, so we've got these line stows here that not only help to slow the opening, but also help to keep the lines nice and neat so we don't get any knots or any entanglements or anything like that, because we want to use this main parachute. We don't want to use the reserve, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
Don't want to use the reserve.
No, because it costs money to repack it.
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna pull this out. All the tension on that pilot chute is what's helping pull this out. And then all of a sudden, out comes the canopy. Canopy is what we call parachutes. It pulls it right out. And then we've packed it in such a manner that this canopy wants to open. Those nose cells are gonna grab the air and inflate the canopy all the way up so it's above John's head. And flying nice and pretty. Now, as this parachute is opening, it has a slider attached to it. This slider helps, again, to slow the canopy opening and keep these lines all separated and nice and pretty. So it starts at the top and it works its way down here,
yep,
right by these risers. Now, in some cases, people leave that slider open while they're flying. The tandem parachutes, you'll see the sliders flapping in the breeze, no big deal. But for our smaller parachutes, we really don't want that extra drag. So some people have removable deployment systems, or at least they're going to minimize that drag by pulling these.
And collapse it.
Yep. These two strings here, collapse the slider.
Attached to the parachute lines are our risers. And on the risers, there are dive loops, and there are your steering toggles. And on these steering toggles, they're connected in two areas, on top and then down in the bottom with a pin. And so I stow the excess lines on the back in the little the stow loops. And then you're just ready for, you pull them down once you got a good canopy, you pull it out, and then you grab them and you steer your parachute.
So we pack our parachute so that it, when it opens, it has a slight deflection in the tail, which slows us down.
Correct.
And that's what you saw here. John pulled his toggles out. The toggles are connected to the rear of the parachute, the brake lines, and there, by having it stowed upon opening, that's what slows down the opening and keeps us nice and even.
Yeah, your canopy would be more like this instead of down in a downward dive. It's gonna be a little more up, so it slows
the changes opening. The pitch.
Yeah, change the pitch of your canopy, correct.
That's right. The other thing about toggles is this is how we steer the canopy. So we put it in our hands like this, and we can turn right by pulling right, left by pulling left, and then we can take both of them and push them down, and that's how we slow the canopy and also how we land the parachute. Into the relative wind, slows us down, nice tiptoe landing. So the other thing about risers actually is you can steer your parachute with the risers as well.
You can.
Yeah. So the rears, you can steer very, very well with the rears, and you can even flare your parachute if you had to. The fronts, it really changes that pitch of your parachute, goes a lot more steep, so you'll lose a lot more altitude more quickly by using fronts. So attached to this pilot chute and the bridle, remember our closing pin, which that came out of the closing loop, which pulled this bag out. This bag is what we call the deployment bag, affectionately referred to by skydivers as the D bag. This bag has attached to it already, and there's different kinds of D bags, but in general, this one's pretty standard. And it's got these rubber bands, and that's what you saw, the line stows very nice and neatly organized in here. So we fold the parachute or pack it into this deployment bag so that it safely deploys.
So we're going to talk about the parachute itself in a future segment because there's a lot to know about the canopy. This was pretty basic. We wanted to give you an overview of the container and how the parachute comes out. And we look forward to teaching you more on the parachute itself soon.
That's right.
And now John's going to make me bag the parachute.
Close the barn door.
Right here, there's three rings, and this is what helps. Who left their cell phone on?
Don't watch me do it. Man, when I do it, I'm like a ninja. Chicken, chicken.
Okay, too much. All right, do you want to be the world expert about skydiving or just a nanny muggin?
I'm a nanny muggin.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, I can beat an RSL.
Oh, my gosh. John, basics.
I've done it.
Basics.
I've never beat a
skyhook. We're not talking about a skyhook today.
Oh, we're not talking about skyhook. But it's true. So
it's something. Whew. This is gonna be a rough edit. Okay, good.
With the closing pin. The closing pin is going through.
Like a rattlesnake.
Okay, not everything is an outtake.
No, I was being serious.
Okay. Yeah, too many outtakes. So these are gonna, help me here, help me.
Help me, Tom Cruise.
Help me, Oprah Winfrey.
On mine, I have what they call dive loops, to where I can grab them, which I never use, but a lot of people that are...
Most
people do use them.
Or you can do like John, and he goes like this.
Yeah.
He should have used this. Okay.
You don't want to be called a D-bag.
But this guy wants to be called a D-bag, because he's a D-bag, and that's okay. And that's his purpose in life. So, and...
Seriously.